We've got Barbara Gernat in her studio, and I'm going to ask her a couple of questions while she's painting.
She will try to answer, because it's very difficult to do right brain, left brain stuff. Right brain paint, left brain talk.
So when and why did you start making art?
Probably started in elementary school. I loved my art class. That was my favorite class of the day, other than the lunch, as most kids say. And I love it because I like color. And I think that is the big issue that started me into painting and fiber work, etchings, whatever I did. I just like color and seeing color, along with the lines and values and textures and shapes, you know all those things that that are involved in art.
But what is your medium?
Right now it's oil paint. I have mostly I did watercolors for a long time, and I think a lot of that had to do with my high school training, because my high school teacher was in watercolors. But watercolor was easier to clean up and deal with. Then I moved to acrylics, which I liked, and gave me some of what I wanted in my artwork. But the oils I just love. I love putting the paint on, thick or thin. I love the jewel-like tones that oftentimes have come up with as the light hits the paint, whether it's applied thickly or thinly. I don't limit myself to paints. I do like to draw. I love doing collage. I found a magazine the other day that talked about quilting and paper quilting, and I got really excited about that. So I'm a little schizophrenic, not only in the subjects that I choose to paint, but also in the media.
Speaking of the subjects, what is your muse? What do you get inspiration from?
You know, there's nothing in particular. It's just kind of what hits me, whether it's a landscape, whether it's an animal, whether it's a fish. Sometimes I'll just think, ooh, I want to play with the colors of the fish, so that will lead me to where I want to go. But I'm not hooked into telling a story particularly in my work. I like to let people get involved in the work and let a story develop between the viewer and my painting.
What is your motivation when you're creating art?
To make people happy, to make me happy, first of all, because it's the action of painting, it's the color, it's all the elements of design. But nothing is more exciting to me than when I finish a painting and I go, wow. The only thing that's more exciting than that is when someone else looks at that painting and goes, wow. That's, to me, there's no better compliment, whether they purchase the work or whether they walk away from it and never take it home, because I know it's in their head and gave them a wonderful feeling.
Well, I have a feeling that happens a lot of times with your
work. Thank you. I would hope so. Thanks.
And how did you end up here on the Outer Banks?
My husband and I were interested in the beach area. We lived in Northern Virginia, in the craziness of the traffic outside the D.C. area, and looking for a getaway, so we searched a couple places along the Atlantic coast, and really liked Nag's Head, liked the quiet. I like the colors that are here. And so when we retired, we decided to move down here. And I was driving down, for my final move, although we do have a house in Virginia, but I was driving down and I said, what did I do to myself? I'm so used to the stimuli in the D.C. area. What am I going to do when I get down to the Outer Banks full time, after my week vacation mode? Well, I have not stopped since I've gotten here. It has just been exciting and challenging for me. There are so many things to do. And maybe I shouldn't say all that in case people want to come here. I really cherish the small environment, the small town feel.
Well, wonderful. Thank you so much for having us in your studio
today.
Well,
welcome, and come back anytime.
Absolutely.